हम सब BMS. Okay, it's a fourth session. And now for the transparency features. Okay, here, transparency. What exactly mean by transparency? Okay, this is a feature which is going to hide the complexities of the distributed database. Okay, so distributed database is coming and managing together for the BMS software. Okay, so what are the complexities we are having here? No. Those are hidden, okay, by this transparency features. So that's it. What exactly we are doing initially hides all the complexities of the distributed database. Okay, coming to the next one. Okay, and it will make, okay, this is hiding the complexities. What is going to hide the complexity? This is going to make the user to feel as if he is a single user who is accessing the and working with the centralized database. Okay, so once again, you can observe this picture here. Okay, the different positions, you can come in the requirements. Okay, once you give the access, okay, it is nearby site, here, mother of users, and here, you and all of these are through creation channel. Okay, all these are connected available through this.
Transparency features. Okay, and here it's making the user to feel as if he is the single user who is working with the system. Okay, centralized database. So even they are having the multiple locations, multiple sites, and the database is placed in the different location, still he may feel, okay, as if he is only the single user who is using the database. Okay, so that exactly. Okay, so here, distributed transparency. So what do you mean by this distributed transparency is, it is going to, this feature is going to treat the distributed database as the centralized database. And it also eliminates the need of a user, okay, for partitioning the data, replication of the data, okay, over the multiple sites. You try to understand. This is the transparency. Okay, immediately, what is the point you are getting in your mind? It is hiding the complexity, no? I am talking about the which feature? Distributed transparency. Okay, it is, even though it is distributed, it is making the user to feel as if this is a centralized database. That is the first point. And here it is a distributor. Now it eliminates the user, okay, to think, need for, okay, making the replicas and partitioning of the database over the multiple sites. Okay, try to understand here. Okay, distributed transparency. Okay, it treats, even though it is in the multiple sites, this feature, it is hiding the complexity. Here it is not necessary for the user to know it is in the different locations. Okay, it makes the user to feel as if he is working with one database, right? And coming to the second one, that is called as the, okay, transaction transparency. Okay, transaction transparency. Transaction, okay, familiar, right? The word is very clear. And transaction, see, here the user is requesting. Okay, so where it will go? Nearby site. I mean, your database is in the different sites. Okay, so when the user is requesting, I mean, when he is giving one transaction, okay, the request will go to that so-and-so database. Okay, and here also it is treating the database as a centralized database only. Right. So here, when the transaction is processed there, what it should happen? It should successfully complete the transaction. Okay, we all know what you mean by transaction. Okay, whenever the user is giving any work to the system to process, that is nothing but one transaction. So here the transaction, before the transaction, after the transaction. So your database must be in a consistent state. It must be in a consistent state. So here, transaction transparency, what it is going to do, it is able to update the data over the multiple locations or multiple sites. Multiple, whatever the databases you are having in the different locations, all that data is going to be updated Okay, with this, with the help of this communication network. Means here, what exactly I want to say? When the transaction is processed here, no. Okay, the transaction, before the transaction, after the transaction, your data must be in a consistent state. And you try to understand, the data is not only here, in the different locations also. Maybe the fragment, maybe the fragment is stored in the different location, or the replicas may be present at the different locations. So all those has to be updated successfully so that it can maintain the consistent state of the database. So that, how it is storing, how it is updating, all that will be hidden from the user. Okay, because the purpose of going to the transparency feature itself is called as the, transparency feature itself is called as the hiding the complexity. Right? So transaction, whenever it's given at one particular site, updates will be done in the different sites. Okay, with the help of the communication network. Okay, hope understood this. Coming to the failure. Okay, failure transparency. So what do you mean by this failure transparency? Okay, see, observe, one user is giving the transaction. And assume, there is a failure here. Computer A is not working. Okay, now what happens here? This is going to, stop this. It will not ask the user to stop the transaction. Okay, it will send the control to the other site. Okay, when the transaction is given here and the system is failed, what it will do? Okay, it will send the control to the next site. Okay, so whatever the function, operational function stopped here, that will continue working in the next site. Means the user is here, the complexity is hidden. Okay, what complexity is hidden? Here it is not making the user to know, it is not working here, it is working in the other site. Okay, so that is the use of failure. Okay, transparency. Hope you all are understanding. Here I am talking about the failure. Failure means, say your database is in a different location, and you assume in one location your database is not working properly. Okay, but user request has gone to that particular site, and it is finding, there is a problem. So your control will go, the request will go to the other site. Because the database is available here and it is also available in the other site. Means your control will go to that particular site and your request will be processed there. So here the user is not knowing, it has failed here. In one location, that's why it is going to the next location. All that complexity will be hidden. Because of this failure transparency. So that is also hiding the complexity there. Hope understood. Okay, now coming to the next one, that is called as the performance transparency. This everybody knows again, because performance, quick results, immediately it is responding, faster processing is nothing but the performance. So here, when we come to the performance, when the user is requesting, immediate response should come to the user. Okay, because your data is available, here multiple users, number of users increases, then here the process will be slowing down. Okay, but here it cannot slow down. Why? Because your databases or your replicas are in the different locations, your fragments are in the different locations. It will avoid the degradation of the performance. Hope you are understanding. Okay, I'm talking about the performance transparency. Performance ka matlab, immediately, quick results it should give. Okay, transparency also, it is treating the data as a centralized database. Okay, why? In order to avoid the degradation of the performance. Okay, in order to degrade the performance, right? So here, we're talking about the performance transparency. Performance transparency. What it is going to do, it also provides an efficient way, how to access the data present in the different locations. So if at all it is providing the efficient way to access the data present in the different locations, means quicker results we are getting, faster response we are getting, right? Okay, so that's why we can say it is improving the performance. Okay, for improving the performance also, this transparency feature is helping, right? And coming to the heterogeneity transparency. So what do you mean by this heterogeneity transparency? We are familiar with the two words, okay, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Okay, heterogeneous is different. So what do you mean by this different? And we all have studied that DDBMS is nothing but having a multiple DBMS. So multiple DBMS, okay, this database, this database, this database, in order to manage, we have DBMS here, DBMS here, DBMS here. Right, ma? Okay, DDBMS will have the multiple DBMS in the different locations. Okay, in the multiple sites. Understood? No. So here, that DBMS here, DBMS here, DBMS here may not follow the same data model. Okay, are you able to understand? Data model. Okay, data model. Okay, familiar. Okay, that is relational data model, hierarchical data model. Okay, network data model. Okay, these are the different data models we are having. Okay, along with the object-oriented data model. Okay, entity relationship model. Okay, there are different data models we are having, right? So here, let's take hierarchical, network, relational. So in the different sites, they may be following the different data models. Okay, in using this DBMS. So here, actually, what I am talking about, heterogeneity. Heterogeneity means different types. Okay, different types of models are used in the different locations, but still it is going to provide the interface where it is going to translate the different request, okay, which will be understood in one particular interface, and their request will be processed. Okay, means it will not make the user to know actually in the different locations they are using the different data models, that way it will take time to process. Okay, that complexity also will be hidden, okay, when we are taking the heterogeneity transparency. Okay, so all these whatever we discussed, those are nothing but the DDBMS transparency features. Okay, there is a continuation topic, just it will take 10 minutes. Okay, based on these topics only, okay, we are having something called DDBMS, okay, system designing. Okay, yes. Okay, so it is making what? It is providing the different features. Okay, like it is making the user to have the high performance getting. Okay, it is used to achieve the high performance, availability and reliability. Okay, these are the terms everybody knows. Performance, because it is available in the different locations, performance is improving because it is providing the efficient way to go to the different location and access the data. Getting, okay, replication, okay, performance, it is allowing or achieving to have the high performance and availability. Because of this replication only, okay, we are making the copy and we are making keeping in the different location. Okay, so that's why we can say it is providing the availability. And the next one, what we are discussing, okay, reliability. Reliability means, you remembered, I hope, failure I was talking. Okay, if it is not available in one location, it is making the transaction to process in the other location. Okay, so how all those things are possible? With the help of replication. Hope you are understanding. Replication, transparency. Okay, so it is providing, it is allowing the user to achieve the high performance, availability and the reliability. Okay, so with these strategies, with these objectives, your distributed database designing should be done. Okay, understood, I hope. And when I discuss about this, immediately after few points, again I'm getting the data replication. I'm talking about the only replication. Now I'm talking about the data and it is creating the different copies. And here when I come to the data, I have to tell one more point here. The data is nothing but which is storing in the form of a table database. Okay, the data is in the form